Y'all, let's go. Let's go. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Battle of the Sexes. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Happy. Hey, Margie. Let's go. Let's go. We want to say happy birthday to Sneaky Phil. Hey, Mama E. Y'all tap that screen. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah. Let's go. What's up, downtown, brah? What's happy birthday? We playing this song for you. It's Margie's birthday today, y'all. What's up, Coach Cooley? Let's go. Happy birthday. Oh, that's a blessing. Happy birthday. Hey, Lois. Happy birthday, Margie. Let's go, y'all. King JB is in the building. Let's go, let's go, let's go. What's up, King?
What's happening? What's happening?
Talk up, man. Talk loud, man.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
How you doing?
Oh, man. Pretty good. Speaking of birthdays, I actually just celebrated one myself this past Sunday.
Well, congratulations. Happy belated, man. You 39?
39 now, yes.
Uh-oh, you almost out of them 30s, man.
Almost. It's the last year.
Awesome, man. What, did you do anything special?
I caught up on some much needed sleep.
Don't even talk about it. I'm so frustrated, man.
I'm not gonna tell it. I'm gonna let you make it. I'm gonna let you have it.
You don't even have to say nothing, dog. Hey, Coach Angel, you don't even have to say nothing, dog.
I'm gonna let you have it.
You don't even have to say nothing, dog. You ain't about to say nothing, dog. What's up, Yella? Come on in here, Yella. Hey, Coach Angel.
Hello.
We got another birthday person in here, Margie Jack. Y'all make sure y'all say happy birthday to Margie Jack. She just turned 63 today. Sneaky, we playing this song for Sneaky in his absence. And happy belated birthday to King. So all of us, let's just sing happy birthday, okay? Let's just sing happy birthday. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Happy birthday. Hey. Happy birthday.
Hey.
All you, baby. All you.
Hey, King, this goes out to you since it's your birthday. King, this for you and Margie and Sneaky. Hey.
What's up, buddy?
All right.
It's King's birthday.
King's birthday.
Hey, now, ladies and gentlemen, it's about that time.
Well, good evening, but it's a Margie's birthday. It's King DB birthday. It was this past Sunday, the right day that the Cowboys lost to the Cardinals. And it's Sneaky's birthday. His daughter is feeding him tonight. They're cooking dinner. I think he said they're cooking him dinner. He got a special dinner planned for him. So here we are. Okay, we're going to ladies go first.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday to him.
Who?
Little Mama's son.
Little Mama. Okay, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Yeah. All these birthdays. So what sign are you?
Libra.
Libras.
Wow. Are Libras good people?
I am. I can't speak for nobody else.
Hey, King said, I'm like, hey, I can only speak for myself. He turned to it. He's a true Libra. Okay. Well, Coach Angel, you go first. Introduce yourself to everybody. What's your mental tonight? Then we'll go to King, and then we'll go to Yellow.
Okay, so I am Coach Angel, and I am an author, a speaker, a voiceover person. And it's my new talent, Yella. I did write the book. It's a journal. It's a self-guided journal for healing. It's called Hunt the Good. So I do that.
Go ahead, King.
My mental is a 10.
She's 10.0. I like that. Why you a 10? Why you a 10 today? Have you done anything special to be a 10? Why you a 10 today?
I'm a 10 today because, I turned 50 in January. So, which is great, right? I had a friend who's a one-star general reach out to me. We've known each other for years and years through the Army. But he reached out to me because we're office co-workers and said, hey, do you want to come to Saudi Arabia and I'll take you to Dubai? And I said, absolutely.
Awesome.
And, hey, Cynthia. I'm going to visit with him and his wife. And we're going to stay in like a military compound, and he has obviously security detail and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, so he's paying for everything. So all I have to do is get my passport and I'm going in February.
Just be careful now. Don't fuss with a car on the place when you go to Dubai. Don't be fussing with the men over there.
No. I'm not.
Lord, all right, go ahead. Okay,
hold up, King. King, Yell, and then Rory. Y'all hold up. Let's let Shan introduce herself and tell us what her mental is. And did you get that plumbing situation fixed?
We can't hear you, Shannon. Who has
on? There she go. Okay, go ahead, King.
King DB. I'm just I'm the youngest among us. A now recently 39-year-old grandfather, just navigating my way through life, man. My mental is actually again. I just blew out 39 candles, like. I'm grateful for everything that's going on with my life going on at this point. And my mental is at a 10.
That's good. That's good. That's good. And we want to send out love to Eva and her family. They're going through another bereavement. There's another funeral tomorrow. And so we send much love to her and her family. And we're going to get Shan and T. Michelle and them into the hot seat so we can get them back on so their audio is working. I think T. Michelle is getting a new phone, and I don't know if she's got it, but we're going to get them in here. So go ahead, Yell, and then we want to hear from Heat Miser.
We can't hear him.
I got you.
There we go.
I was on mute.
Hey, Meredith.
Hello, everybody. Welcome in. I do appreciate y'all being here. Thank you so very much. It was a good day today. Yesterday my mental was about on a 4. I was ready to straight Harry Carey people. But you know, I sometimes you just gotta let go and let things happen the way it happens. Then I got up this morning and hosted the cafe. And baby, that was one of the best cafes I hosted in a long time. And it was the topic awesome. The topic was on cereal. It was all about cereal. I'll discuss later on, but it made me laugh so hard for an hour discussing cereal. Yeah, it was good.
All right, Rory, tell us how you doing? How was your week? How's your mental? Then we go to Mo, Shan, E, and Tanya.
My mental has been I want to say 7.5 to yesterday. Now it's 7.9.5. Out of here. Can y'all hear me?
Yeah, talk a little bit louder. Get a little bit closer to the mic.
No, there's a serious echo.
Yeah, it's echo.
Huge, huge echo. And it's very loud.
Should I drop out and come back in?
I'll mute.
Yeah, try that. Okay, go ahead, E, and then go ahead, Miss Tanya.
The funeral is actually today.
Oh.
Okay.
I hear the echo too.
Dr. Zim, do you have a Bluetooth on?
No. Let me see. Let me turn off Bluetooth. I don't, but let me turn it off.
I turned it off, so just in case. Let me hear you again.
Much better.
Oh, we're
much
good better. Now.
It was you.
Okay.
You were the problem.
It was you.
Considering everything, my mental is a 7. I'll give it a 7. I can smile.
Okay. So. Okay. Come on, Tanya.
Hey, everyone. Happy Wednesday. I'm going to say that I'm about a 7. You know, got some things going on, but I'm working through it. The girls have to hear me bitch about it, but that's besides the point.
Okay. You okay? You okay?
Yes. 100%.
Okay. When is Alex coming home?
He will be here Saturday.
Oh. That is good. You ready?
Nope.
But we'll talk offline. Listen. We'll talk offline because I got to come back and visit y'all.
I'm happy that my child is coming home, so I don't have to worry about him. I know he's here. He's safe with me. But as a woman in the age that I am at, there's a lot of things that change and a lot of things that come into play. Right. So my goal when he gets here is to educate and get him straight. So he ain't got to live with mama too long.
Yeah. Yeah. What you say? You're going to put him on he's going to have a shelf life, huh?
That part.
Yes. All right. Mo, tell us how you doing. Mo, long time no see or hear from. How you doing?
I'm making it. I'm finally back at home, finally done traveling. I'm pretty sure for the rest of the year, glad to not have to put no more drawers and bras in a box to go somewhere. So that's a good thing. Struggling through a little bit, feeling a little under the weather. I had my COVID booster, like the 2023 booster. What was that, Tuesday? Right. And it's kind of hit me, so I'm feeling a little like, but it is what it is, you know. But hey, blessed and not stressed. So hey,
all right. Rory, go back over your mental. Shan, go over your mental. And as we talk, and Coach Angel is going to open up our discussion tonight. Everybody, when it's your turn to speak, you got 60 seconds, or you got 90 seconds to say your piece. And go on and pass the baton, pass the mic, because we got a full house tonight, and we want to give our topic due diligence tonight. Modern women say that they protect their man, true or false? So, Rory, your mental, how you been? You said about a 7.5. How you doing? And then Shan, and then Coach Angel is going to open up the discussion tonight.
I was at a 7.5, and then yesterday I went and got a haircut. So now I'm about 9.5 because I'm back fine again.
Mm-hmm.
Chocolate.
Do you even know who Heat Miser is? Do you know that reference?
No, I don't.
YouTube it.
I'm glad to be back on top, back looking good, back like I never left.
All right, and you know we on for next Friday, me, you, and Logan.
Yes, sir.
I'm on my way to Austin, baby. All right, Shan, how's your mental? How you doing? And how's your mental?
I'm fixed.
Talk loud.
And my coach. I'm at a 10.
All right, Coach Angel, you got the floor.
Okay, so topic is, do you,
hey, Chris.
Does a modern woman protect her man? And so I would say, yes, we do. We're not talking about physical protection. Because obviously, I don't know that that can always be done. I know I can't physically protect my man, per se. Right. But what I can protect him from is embarrassment in public. I can protect him from himself. I can protect him from others. You know, there are definitely things where I can protect him. I can protect his heart. I can protect his mind, you know, and be there for him.
That's right.
But not, you know, maybe not physically in the sense physically, but, you know, protection in as far as, you know, not embarrassing him means, okay, so he does something in public, you don't right. like it, throw him that eye, like, you know, you're going to hear about this. But then wait right. until you get in the car or get home. Don't embarrass him in public. Don't shame him by any means. Don't use his vulnerabilities against him. Don't weaponize them against him. That's how you protect your man. But that's just me.
That's good. So, fellas, do you agree or disagree? Do the women in your life, Yella, you speak to this. Does your wife protect you?
Hold on. But Doc Sims, this is your table, and I respect your table, but I want to hear the rest of the women before I make any type of comment. I want to hear the rest of the ladies speak to this topic, if you don't mind, okay. sir.
Come on, ladies. Come on. How do y'all feel like? Do y'all protect y'all men? Talk to us tonight. Are men worth protecting? Y'all, I want to poke some bears tonight. Y'all awful quiet tonight. Let's go.
Yeah. You're choosing simple assault. Not quite violence, but you're choosing simple assault tonight.
Y'all talk. How do y'all protect y'all man? That's one of y'all responsibilities, right?
Right. It is. I would say the way I would is by, one, making home a safe space for him where he can be vulnerable. He can have his emotions. He can be angry. He can do what he needs to do. And it's a safe space. I'm not going to use it against him later, 3 days later in a fight. Like, that's not what a real woman who's protecting her man should do. But also everything she said, you don't embarrass him in public. You let him know about himself later on. But you
later on,
you just look at him like
But hey, wait a minute, E. Before we, Mo, we're gonna get to you because you know eyes are coming up there with that notebook. We're gonna get to Mo, but we gotta sing happy birthday to Sneaky. Sneaky's in the video, y'all. Let's give it up for Sneaky. It's his birthday today. Sneaky.
I'm gonna give it to myself.
Happy birthday.
Hey.
I can't say long, so hopefully thank you for letting me jump in real quick, fast.
Happy birthday to you, big boy.
I want to say I love you guys and thank you for all the birthday wishes. But I want to address the subject. I am the most protected. Hopefully y'all can hear me. Hopefully I'm not too loud.
Mm-hmm. You're fine, perfect.
You're fine.
Okay. I am the most protected black man on this planet by my wife. Okay. This is after 23 years of service, 10 years working in the Middle East, and just fighting this planet, just being a minority in the United States of America.
Yes, sir.
Nobody attacks me with my wife around. Nobody belittles me with my wife around. Mm. If I'm out doing some shenanigans and I'm not paying attention, she's like, come here. Did you see what that person did or said? Nobody defends me harder than my wife. And in that regard, in the past, I had been lacking. Now, since then, I've swore to her I'd never let it happen again because no one's going to do anything against my wife in my presence and not walk away unscathed. But
right.
I'm with A. Marie there. I am protected.
That's good. I so am protected. Again, go into some more details real quickly. I know you got to go. And then we got to hear from Mo and Tanya. So how does your wife physically, emotionally, spiritually, mentally, all that, how does she keep you guarded? How do you, she keeps you protected?
It depends on the situation. If it's something where she feels, if I don't speak up on my own, if she feels that I should say something, she gives me that. She gives me that.
That gentle,
unspoken language that you have in a marriage. All right. That's that thing like, boy.
That look.
Oh, I got you. That type of thing. Sometimes my wife would just jump in the middle of a conversation and be like, wait a minute, you lost your mind. That's not going to happen. All right.
Yeah.
I have December the 28th this year, we'll be married for 38 years.
Wow.
She knows me. I know her. She's my strength. I'm her foundation. We are a family. My girls are productive citizens of the United States of America. They know how to act. Yeah. But when I'm lacking, she's the reinforcement.
That is good stuff, man. Well, what you got playing with the girls? What they got playing for you real quick?
Oh, I just ran upstairs real quick. They said, you coming right back? I was like, yeah, baby. Look, they fixed me my favorite. I'm sorry. They fixed me my favorite meal. We're all downstairs. Grandbaby, all four of my daughters. My daughter came in from Charlotte. The whole family's here just for my birthday. And I'm loving it, and I can't stay too long. I love you guys. And,
we love you, man.
Yeah, I'm watching, but I love you guys, and I got to bounce out of here. Y'all take care.
Hey, okay, boy. Love you, big man.
Love you,
all right, all right.
That's good stuff right there. Mo, I saw that look in your eyes. Mo, talk to us, Mo.
You're muted.
Yeah, I was trying to stay quiet. All right. So first off, y'all know I'm real big on definitions. Okay. So protect by definition, couple of things. So as a verb, keep safe from harm or injury. Similarly, preserve or guarantee by means of formal or legal measures, as in free speech is protected by Article 33 of the Constitution. And then secondarily, aim to preserve by legislating against hunting collectively, developed. Okay, fine. I don't know that I'm so gung-ho into that as I am so much in the synonyms. Okay. So the synonyms are defend, guard, safeguard, and shield. I think I more lean into the synonyms rather than the protect itself.
Okay. And that's what we feeling. That's what we feeling tonight. That's what we feeling. That's what Coach Angel was talking about. And we depend on y'all for that.
Okay. And
sometimes
so
we have to protect them from themselves.
Yeah. Yep. I'll buy into your synonyms. I don't know that you're gonna be able to sign me into the actual, the whole keep safe from harm or injury. Oh shit.
Right.
Guard, safeguard, or shield. Okay, yeah, sign me up, coach, sign me up. But keep safe from harm or injury. Oh shit.
Sometimes we need y'all to do that because y'all got a voice sometimes that can help us out in a situation.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, but that whole absolute, ledge of keep safe, I'm like, oh shit, that has a different level of onus. That has a different level of guarantee. I'll shield you from some shit. A shield ain't a guarantee. It ain't a, but the whole keep safe from harm and injury, listen, I can't guarantee I'll keep you safe. I will shield or warn you of some shit. Now, I'm good for that. Tell you, there's a bear 50 clicks out. Okay, get that ham sandwich. I'll do that. Okay, I will do that. But if you are expecting me, when that bear
want you to fight the bear. We got the bear. Just tell me where he is. I got the bear.
Fine. Hey, I'm gonna hold a ham sandwich. I'm gonna run this way, and you tackle that motherfucker, and I'm gonna be on the other side with your glass of water. I got you, baby. That's what.
Mo, I'm flying into Houston. I'm gonna holler at you, but see, I done read your transcript. The folks told us if you in a fight with a bear, we better help the bear.
Listen. Okay, but yeah, so because in all of these conversations, the whole provision protection thing is so heavy, and it's so, for men, it is so laden with so much onus and so much, I hesitate to take that on for myself. That's why
I understand
the synonyms. So
I like
the shielding, the safeguarding, the defending. 100%. I'm going to let you know. Hey, don't fuck with that shit over there. That motherfucker crazy. Watch out for this shit. Hey, this shit is coming up. I will point all of that out. I will let you know.
So that begs the question. Rory had his finger up, but and I'm going to piggyback on what y'all are saying. Rory, you go ahead. He had his church finger up. So that begs the issue. We need to listen. If y'all are going to be there for us, we need to listen to y'all, right?
Woo. Come on, somebody.
Okay.
What did Beyonce say? Listen to the song that's in my soul.
She can sing too. Come on, Rory. Rory.
Go ahead, Rory. I'm sorry.
First of all, it's Kelly over Beyonce every day. Secondly, so I hear what you're saying with the synonyms, but I'm by no means as smart as you. I'm probably the dumbest one in the panel. I joined the Marine Corps, so that lets you know where my mental is. When you say the synonyms, aren't synonyms built to be used interchangeably?
Not necessarily inherently, somewhat so, yes, but not inherently and emphatically, no.
Because when you say shield, if I'm wearing a helmet, that helmet shields, it protects my head from shrapnel. Or that flak jacket protects my body from shrapnel. It shields or protects my body from shrapnel. I hear what you're saying, but I just want to get a clearer understanding, because when you say, no, I'm not going to protect, but I'll shield, shielding is a form of protection, is it not?
So, it's all in a nuance. And so that's what I was speaking to in terms of wanting to lean towards a synonym rather than protect, because of how protect has become so laden with, you know, so many other things because of the discourse that's happening around it. That's why I don't want to touch on it. I would rather use these other terms because they're not so heavy inherently with other things.
Right.
I'll tell you this, baby girl, I appreciate you just for shielding me.
Hey, look at Yella. Look at Yella. Yella, what were you going to say, Yella? And then we're going to listen to Tanya.
Well, what I was about to say totally got negated after what Mo said, because she brought up a good word. Well, no. That's a good thing, because you redirected my thought. And
That's good. That's good input.
And redirection brings up the word shield. A lot of people think shield for protection, but also for you to be my shield is also you're a source of deflection. Because if a shield cannot deflect what is coming to you, you're a worthless shield. Mm-hmm. So you actually made me think about not just so much in the word protection, just the word shield. If you're going to be my shield, you need to be very apt to deflect whatever is coming my way. Even if you don't think you're doing a lot, the slightest deflection can save your life. And
That's good. Because there's some things us men just don't want to think about, and we really lean on you guys to handle for us. There's some things we don't want to deal with, and you guys are suited for that. You know, but go ahead, Tanya. What are some of your thoughts, Tanya?
Yeah, piggybacking off of that, it's always trying to be that one step ahead, right? So that you can see the things that he doesn't see coming. You can see that perspective that he may not have. Because maybe he is in such a space working, whatever the case may be, he doesn't see it, but you do. You let him know, right? It's all of those things. And then it goes back to what Amari said. You could be dead ass wrong, but I ain't gonna say that shit to you in front of anybody else.
Nope.
Right. I'm gonna tell you in the bedroom, boo, you dead ass wrong. But that's, I'm always going to defend. I'm always going to make sure I have your back. I'm always going to try to stay one step ahead of you. Always going to try to see what is coming for you and for us. And make sure that you are the first one that knows, this is what I see.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's yeah. gonna be my yeah. that's what I how I'm gonna move.
Yeah, you get out somewhere and you hear somebody say, you know, I'm gonna whoop that punk ass motherfucker Rory's ass. They'd be like, woo, did you hear Yellow was talking about your ass? Oh, they'd be like, baby, Rory, let's go. I want some Waffle House. Let's go, baby. Let's
you want to come out. On the hot seat candy? Let me say.
Come on. This how yellow folks do y'all, it for yellow folks. This is not the deflection I was talking about, sis. This ain't it.
That was good. I think you need to somebody want to sit in on the hot seat. She said she got story. Good evening again, everybody. How's everybody doing tonight? Girl. Go ahead and put your mental in a box. We'll address everybody's mental. We got Hard Candy that's in the hot seat for 3 minutes. She wants to chime in because she says she's got stories about this topic tonight. Hard Candy, okay. Introduce yourself. Good evening.
It's somebody but Lily. Yella knows I am full of stories because I'm just a firecracker and I just run amok. I do be running amok.
Good evening.
So I'm gonna take y'all back. What year did Quentin get married? Do you remember? 2016. Our cousin got married. Right. The first wife was there with her paramour. I was there with Kirk. And they did we need to go talk about the kids. So she told him to stay here, and Kirk told me to stay where I was. So when this church was built, I was like up on some steps with the grandbaby. And I can see out across the whole parking lot. I saw the paramour walking up on his back behind him. So he had his back turned, and the paramour was walking up a little too fast for my comfort.
Okay.
So I shoved the grandbaby inside with some more cousins, and I kind of come off them stairs, and I'm cutting him off going, they need to talk. They asked us to stay here. Okay. He's going to raise his voice at me and proceed to continue to walk up on his blind side. Oh, no. I will kick off these shoes right here in this parking lot and cause a whole half a scene. A whole half a scene. Because you're not going to walk up on his blind side.
I like that.
You're
like
not going to be on his blind side. And if I can see, you're not going to be.
Mm-hmm. Okay, she said, I got the 6, the 9, and the 3.
And the 3. Facts.
Oh, look.
Big facts.
We appreciate that. We appreciate that, Hard Candy. What's your first name? You Lily?
He didn't appreciate it. That day he didn't, but when I explained what I saw, he was like, oh, okay, oh, I got, okay, you good, thank you.
Yeah, that he said, thank you. Well, thank you for chiming in. We appreciate you tonight.
Wait, Kurt. Wait, hey. So.
Thank you for chiming in, my friend.
Thank you.
Hey, we got James in the building. James is back, y'all. Let's see if we can get him in here.
And while he's coming up, you know, it's not necessarily all about the physical. I remember a guy that I was dating, and during our talking phase, as we're just mentioning miscellaneous things, you know, I remember everything that I hear and I catalog it. And so when we go out to eat and he's ordering, you know, whatever the restaurant we were at, something clicked for me. And when his dish came out, he was about to take a bite. I said, no, stop. And he's like, what are you talking about? I called the waiter back over and I said, wait a minute, is there fish sauce in this dish? And he was like, yeah. I said, you told me you're allergic to seafood. And he was like, oh my God, like you remembered that? I'm like, yeah, no, take this away.
Yeah, see, and he that's was good like, looking out. That's paying attention. That's good looking out. Hey, y'all, we got a celebrity in the building. I'm fixing to play his theme song right quick. I'm finna play his theme song. We got a celebrity. This is Mr. God. Sexy Man, y'all. Bishop JT. James Taylor.
You got a theme song, JT?
Wagwan JT. How y'all doing, man?
Look at James.
This is where we're going now. I I am so done right now.
I don't think Bishop is impressed.
Hey, James, how you been, man? Tell us, everybody, how you doing? What's your mental to tonight? And we're talking about women, the women that protect their men, my brother.
Are they standing in front of bullets?
Not necessarily.
Depends on what kind of bullets that's being tossed to you.
That was very nasty.
Listen, this ain't a Bruno Mars song. What the fuck is we talking about? Ooh, she said.
Insane.
Look at Bishop.
No.
Insane.
You all right? You're doing a lot right now. You understand? You're doing a lot.
Hey, JT, understand, my brother.
I love that accent.
For you, me no catch no bullets for your brother.
If you ain't willing to die, if you ain't a ride or die, you don't love me. You understand? What's the dollar plan? No, I'm doing good, man. I'm adjusting to, I'm getting my legs underneath me. I'm a single father. I'm getting it.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? I can't sit in certain stands. You know what I'm saying? I used to be able to sit with the married folk. You know, now I'm over there with all the single mothers. It's very treacherous over there. I ain't never got so many pound cakes and apple cheesecakes and pies and potato salads and raisins in my life. But you know what? I want to thank God.
Not potato salads with raisins.
Player.
And she did it with confidence. She was like,
that's why.
But James, we want to know real quick, James, has anybody baked you something that has caught your attention?
Hold on. Wait. Before you answer that. When Dr. Sims says we want to know, he's really saying he wants to know. So I just want to clarify that. I just want to clarify that.
That's right.
As a man of God, I don't never want to make nobody feel bad. I appreciate all of what the ladies have done for me. Right now, though, I'm giving it out to my kids. Okay.
not the Tessa.
I got. Hey, Tammy. Hey, good evening again, everybody. Y'all continue to tap the screen. We're up to 5,000 likes now. We want to get to 10,000. We got about 52 people in the room, and we got a very hot topic tonight. If you want to get in on the hot seat, let us know. We got a big topic tonight. But as you peruse this new community, young man, the single folk, what are you looking in particular as far as the next Mrs. Taylor? Is there any one outstanding attribute you're looking for?
Right now, I'm not looking for anything. I just want to go on record. I'm just trying to heal. I really don't.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? Which I need to pray for me for is pray for me about that notch that's been throwing at me. That's what you need to pray for.
And listen, on behalf of all the single bitches that's out here in the free range, thank you for understanding that you don't need to be bothered with nobody at this point because you're trying to work on yourself. Because the very worst and most disingenuous thing that will end up with you getting the windows bust out your car.
All right now. Come on, somebody.
Yeah, I've been out with my friends. These streets are filthy. No disrespect to anybody out there. I went to the.
Hey, man.
This is how I know I'm older and I don't know what's going on. I walked into the place. It was dark. I started crying because I thought people were smoking crack. Then I found out it was hookah. I was like, oh, Lord, they're going to hell. Broad daylight, crack in the open. We started smoking crack in broad daylight. Big old pipes.
You know what? No.
Look at Ken.
Okay. Yeah. You stay your ass in the house. You stay your ass in the house for a little while longer. Your cake ain't finished baking. God damn it. That's right there. Yet. Yeah. No, you ain't ready yet, baby. You ain't ready yet.
They charge $500 for a seat. $500 for a seat. It's called a section. Mm-mm. You can look at people and tell their credit score is less than 580. You pay for that section.
Pass.
You need to pay for credit repair. You need to pay for credit repair. Well, I ain't judging. I'm just saying.
You ain't judging.
Need to take your class for your upcoming conference.
I cannot.
But hey, no, James, go ahead and give James, go ahead and do your commercial for your conference. Go ahead.
Oh, so on November 16th through the 18th, I have what we call the Just Be Conference, where we build your business and you master your mind. We help you to grow your credit score, fix your credit. We actually have a masterclass where you come in. We're going to have some computers open, and you're going to go ahead and fix your credit right there on the spot. You're going to have several people walking around helping you put that in there. We're even going to have the letters on deck that you can mail at the same time. We're going to have stamps, letters, mails for you to do that. But on the other side, we have a whole track of just emotional intelligence. We're going to have a panel discussion about sex. We're going to have a panel discussion about relationships, being a widower. It's going to be really good. And there's two parts to the conference. There's one just for the students that they can come and enjoy themselves, and they'll have the same teachers everybody else have, but it'll be something that is for them that they can enjoy and grow themselves. And then I have sessions for us as adults that'll be really good. Some of the panel discussions, we can have that. And then Friday night will definitely be Afrobeats and Jamaican night. And then Saturday night will be an all 70s party. And just so you know, we'll have the great host. We got to make his flight arrangements. Those will be taken care of next week, actually. The great Yellow Bull, everybody. Let's give it up for Yellow Bull. He'll be the MC of the day. Yes, sir. So we're really excited about that.
I'm excited.
Hey, and you've invited the Blue Table Talk for Men will be there. We're all planning to be there. We'll appreciate the hospitality. So I'm just going to be a little fly on the wall. I'm going to be soaking everything up, man. Just proud of you, man.
I'll be there with the boys.
I'm really excited about it. If you have students that are ages 12 to 17, they pay for nothing. And there's some of you who say, hey, I got some 20-year-olds, 19-year-olds. They really need this information. They can come for free. What I will never do is charge that age group, because I want them to get the information to grow to become successful. You can also watch it online as well. You can go to justbecon.com, JustBecon.com. That's JustBecon.com. It's going to be a great conference. We're going to have a great DJ, great information. We're going to feed the kids. If you want to donate, all that stuff is on the website. You can see all the courses, the master classes that are going to be available. I am super excited about it. Yeah.
That's going to be a good time.
That's good stuff, man. Let's get that website out one more time.
JustBecon.com. JustBecon.com.
All right, Coach Angel, ask your next. Go to your next point. What else in your notes tonight? We talked about protecting your man. Talk to us.
I don't remember. What did we talk about?
We talked about a lot.
Okay. What do y'all do when we touched on a few minutes ago? What do you do when we won't listen to you? You looking out for us. Remember, we talked about that in pre-production. We have a hard time. We're hard-headed. Men are hard-headed.
Yes, y'all can be very hard-headed. I say that with the abundance of love. I have two sons, and they are equally as hard-headed. And it comes down to trust as well. So it also is a temperature gauge, right, even for the relationship as a whole. Because if the man doesn't trust me to listen to me, and that what I'm telling him is going to be important to him, you know, like Hard Candy made a comment about, you know, and she was like, no, look, see here.
right.
And sometimes we have to get that see here, and then we'll explain it to you later. But definitely, it comes down to the trust. You guys have to trust the person that you're with in order to know that she has undoubtedly got your back all times.
Yeah. So where do you, because T just made a comment, and And she said, she said, I'm gonna let you make that bed up hard and you're gonna lay in it, and then I'm gonna give you the side eye and say, I told you so. But where's that line though? If you supposed to be looking out for us, is that a good philosophy? I'm gonna let you bump your head and you'll eventually get it, and then I'm gonna just stand there and look at you and say, I told you so. Is that a good philosophy?
No, but I can tell you there was a time in my marriage where he didn't listen to me, and I told him even after when he was going into his second marriage, like, I don't know about that. And he didn't listen. And now he's, you know, unfortunately, it didn't last for him.
Yeah.
You go tried to on, save Mom. A life mm-hmm. after you tried I to destroy one?
Oh, you a real good person. You a I real did. Good person.
And Matt is better than a lot of us.
She's I think it matters the arena and the topic of it. So for me, and what I run into all too often is there's not a lot of like life navigational topics that you're gonna be able to best me in.
I understand.
And what you especially can't best me in 9 times out of 10 is financial. And so I remember with this one particular boyfriend, he was, you know, trying to start a business or whatever. And I was, you know, he was negotiating a transaction. Person gave him a third party check. And I was like, yeah, that shit ain't going to clear. You know, right. that shit is going to bounce better than, you know, a pass between Pippen and Jordan in the finals. You know, I laid out the timetables and everything, and I was like, okay. And he's right. Like, no, you don't know what you're talking about. You know, and I'm like, listen, I'm gonna sit back and watch the play. Let me get my popcorn. Okay. Let me go. You know, let me lace up. You know, and Nathan.
Okay. You know, so fellas, speak to that. Why don't we listen a lot of times, fellas? Y'all speak to that. Do y'all listen all the time? Do we listen all the time?
I'll answer that, and I'll say that especially at a younger point in my life, I was really, really stubborn and thought I knew it all.
What?
Not you.
Not you, King. Look at you.
Accountability is important. Accountability is important in knowing yourself.
See, now the 38-year-old King wouldn't have said that. It took you to be 39 to admit that, see?
Accountability? Yeah.
Not the 39. It's the 12 extra months for me.
It's the 12 right. extra months, dog. Right. Rory, I saw your church finger. Talk to us.
So, about just piggybacking off of King, no, I didn't listen. Because if I wouldn't have listened, I wouldn't have got married. If I would have listened, I wouldn't have got married the first time.
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute now. Unpack that a little bit. What do you mean?
When I told my mama, yeah, she got 3 kids. How old is she, son? She's 20. You sure you want to do that? Yeah, I'm in love, mama. I'm in love, mama. You sure you want to?
Jesus face.
Hey, sugar mama. You sure? Wait a minute, Rory. You didn't listen to mama.
I didn't listen. I was in love. I knew everything. I'm 23 years old.
You, Rory. Listen,
I'm 23 years old.
I will say to
I needed a Shay Shay drink on that one. That was that.
Roy, I'm sorry, bro. That wasn't love. That was lust. That was all lust.
L-U-S-T.
That was lust. That was lust. B-A-Q and B-A-H.
It was that part too. So. Wow. That part. Full rate.
She was throwing that thing like he giving you houses. Yes, she was throwing that thing giving you houses.
T, you got to come in here. T, you in the hot seat. T, I'm putting you in the hot seat. I want to hear from T. T said, I ain't going to tell you but one time. T, you got to talk to us, T. No.
Yeah, T was out there. She was wilding out.
Rory, you were up there thinking with your gray sweatpants, sir. Absolutely yes, not. Absolutely not.
Look, because she put it on me and she could cook, y'all. She from Alabama. She put it on me and she could cook.
Oh, she had the notch, dude.
So not the cornbread and pinto beans, Rory.
She had the yash and some seasoning, and that's all it took.
And she had the yams.
Hey, T, tell us what you mean, T. How many times are you going to tell that man, you shielding him, you protecting him, you're the force field around him. You got him locked on every side. Can't nobody get to him, but he won't listen to you. How many times you gonna talk to him, T?
I'm gonna have the conversation with him once. I'm gonna give him an example as to why what he's doing is not going to work. If he does not understand it at that point, go with God. I'm not gonna argue with you. I'm not gonna keep chasing with you. Over it. I'm not.
You're not gonna do it, T.
Yep.
I'm not.
Y'all need to learn how to be patient.
He's gotta learn the lesson.
100%. 100%.
If I'm giving you the example to go with it, I mean, how much more patient can I get?
But okay, so if I mess up, if I go ahead and cash that third party check and I lose $5,000, you're not going to say I told you so, right?
Wrong. I'm going to tell you I told you.
It got quiet, y'all.
My yellowness will kick you in the
knee. She turned the camera on.
She said my yellowness.
My hand is trembling on this one. $5,000. Oh, Lord.
Listen, I do want you to understand fully that that's exactly what the fuck I did. Reiterated that. Listen, I am Fed ACH certified. Okay, so it ain't like I just came to you with just basic consumer. Listen, I work in the industry. I wasn't even trying to tell you from layman's terms. This is what I do. This is my profession. Okay, so so you decided that's what.
Speaking.
I'll let you take it to the king laying on the altar, baby. But I'm telling you that's what I said.
That part.
Okay, so this is speaking to some people.
If it's what I do and you don't take my advice. We're done.
That part.
Remember, ladies, your little degrees, your little job don't matter. Remember that?
See, mm-hmm. I knew Mo was going there.
You knew she was going there. Thank you, T.
I knew she was going there. Here's the thing, though. We have to address how sometimes things are said. Because, you know,
right.
Mo sound like a sugar mama who would give you a spanking. So you got to kind of process this stuff as a man. You got to be secure in who you are as a man. Oh,
damn.
To be able to say,
Rory, that's another. That's after dark. That's an after talk, Rory. That's after talk.
What I'm saying is, there are times where a woman will communicate something to you, and the tone will throw off the whole conversation.
Because James, you looking in my notes. You looking in my notes. Why aren't we listening to you, James? You got it, James. That's exactly it, James.
I think it's the tone. And here's the thing: I think two can come in. I think both can be wrong at the same time. One, right. Her delivery can be so strong that it makes him feel he's being attacked. But two, she can also be overwhelmed by the fact that he didn't know what to do. Right? Because there are things, there are a lot of assumptions sometimes that a man should know certain things. And honestly, they don't. They don't. And I think we need to be more gracious in that point.
But we can't act like we know it all, though, right?
Ready to cut. Mo ready to cuss already. What is your thoughts, we need safe space right now. I need safe space.
I agree, but I think
women don't listen to men as well. I'm sorry, T. I don't think women listen to men either sometimes based on delivery. So I think it's both.
Of course.
When y'all say something to us, if you come at me highly aggressive, who you talking to? I just had to check this one the other day. Honey, take a little bass out of that voice. Who you think you talking to?
I got delivery. Ladies, delivery is everything. Delivery is everything.
It absolutely matters. But if I come to you and I say to you, look, based on the information that you've given me, here is my opinion. You as a man, I'm going to allow you to do whatever you want to do. The final decision lies in your hands. I'm giving you the basics and I've given you the information, the example, and the reasons why, you don't take that into consideration.
Right.
Whatever happens after that, I can't do shit about. It's on you.
But you're not part of the I told you so crew, though, right? Yes, we don't want to hear I told you so.
In the bedroom.
I was about to say, don't get on here and lie.
Hey, you tell me I told you so at the right time. I'll take it. I'll take the L.
In the bedroom.
So go ahead, Rory.
in the bedroom. That way it's not as painful.
I feel like as men, we need to get over that. Oh, it's the delivery. Sometimes we need to get our attention got. Sometimes we don't listen. Get over it. Oh, it's the delivery. Talk to me nice. Talk. No, F that. Hey, bro, I need you to listen to me. Get. Sometimes I need a woman to get in my face, get my attention. I got ADD real bad. You got to get in my face and get my attention. Hey, yep. Look, snatch me up in my collar. Now, I like a little BDSM, but no, snatch me up in my collar. Okay?
But I may like, hey, now, Rory, are you saying that in public? And it's recorded because we putting on Scooby Gear next Friday, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay. And say, hey, I need you to listen to me. Now, if you hit me with the told you so in the bedroom, I'm going to beat you back out. That's all there is to it. That's all I got.
How we get here?
Here's my thing. Here's my thing with this shit. If a motherfucker told you, hey, if you do this shit this way, your ass gonna get arrested. And listen, I'm a cop, so trust me.
All right, Chelsea King.
You'd be like, hey, I ain't gonna do that shit. But for a bitch to tell you, hey, you if you do this transaction this way, it ain't gonna work out. No. Each case, that is a subject matter expert in that particular field. It's really not any different.
Right.
But to choose to process it differently, that's your choice. That's not my responsibility. How you choose to process subject matter experts in their field of expertise and follow what they give you is on you. As far as that tone and all the rest of that shit, maybe that's where my autism spectrum comes in. Because listen, social cues, tone, and all the rest. Listen, I only process information. That's all I synthesize. I don't give a fuck about tone. Right. What the fuck did you say and how is that pertinent?
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. So this begs the question. Yeah, this begs the question. Because Yella, you speak to this one. How long did it take you to really listen when your wife says something and she's really serious? When did you get to the point where you really knew if she said something, you should listen to her?
Truthfully speaking, and I know we've heard the saying, if I say it the first time, you know, that's the way it should be. The second time.
Okay.
And it's not the second time with, I told you that. It wasn't that. It was... Babe, remember the last time I told you such and such and such? Okay, I'm gonna tell it to you again. That second time has a gentle shove in your face that
yeah.
You know, your head's not gonna snap back, but it's gonna be like this. And you'll be like, okay. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
It's
hard enough to move your head, but not too hard to give you a concussion. So
Dad, come on.
You get that gentle little nudge, and she was like, and she does it often. She'll say, "Remember the last time I told you such and such?"
Right.
Okay. I'm gonna say it to you again. This is about to go down. This is how it was about to happen. Now the 27 years of marriage in me is saying, "Ooh, okay. The lights are going off. The sirens are happening." Okay, you know what? Yeah, all right, baby, I got you.
A little smoke in the kitchen.
I hear what you're saying. And we as men have to really understand and take the ego out of situationships. We got to take the ego out of situationships and listen to the reality of the situationship. That's so I that's why for me, it's that second. The first time I heard you, the second time I'm listening.
That's good, yeah. Okay, we got Mr. Saturday on the hot seat. You got 3 minutes, young man. Introduce yourself, and what's your take tonight?
Hey, man, I'm just a single husband, man, out here living a single life trying to be a husband to somebody, you hear me? But for me, when it comes down to a woman, all you got to do is say it once. Say it the first time means you respect them. That's it. If anybody got to repeat, even as me as a man, I'm not repeating myself. I don't even repeat myself to my children. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Mo trying to figure out what you said when you said single husband.
I'm single by status, husband by mind frame. There's certain places I don't go to, certain things I don't do, certain people I don't talk to. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to preserve my energy for my wife.
Sound like that, but it's cool.
Hey,
that's good, Saturday. That's good.
Coming in here stealing our thunder. All the women cranked up when you said, what the hell wrong with you, man?
Know your place.
Mr. Saturday trying to get hemmed up on Sunday. Hey,
Mr. Saturday, he came here all smooth. He said, I'm a single husband.
If y'all ain't peeped, that was the smoothest game I done see laid down in the motherfucking wild. Bad props to that. That was nice.
When Mr. Saturday said that, he put all of us on reset. I mean, everybody as was like, the hell did he just say?
Hey, I like that beard too, Mr. Saturday. I like that beard, man. You look like a Cowboy fan.
No, oh, man, I'm a good man. I'm gonna make it stop. I incorporated. I don't do it loose.
Hey, man. Yes, sir. So let's go.
I'm gonna go with the Dolphins on that.
Well, hey man. Listen, let me ask you this real quick before you get off the seat. How well do you listen? Because I think that's the defining line of if they repeat it, if they just say it one time. How adept are you to listen that first time? Are you going to get it like Yella said? I'm going to hear you. I heard what you said, but I'm really listening that second time you say that same thing. So how quickly do you listen when they speak the first time?
As well as they communicate. If you communicate the way that I need you to communicate, that I can understand it, I'll listen the first time. Don't get mad at me because you're not communicating the way I needed to hear it. Because if that's you love me, you'll communicate with me the way you know I know how to listen.
Yeah, see, that's how Scarlett does. That's a good point, man. Well, listen, man, it's good to see you, man. Okay, I guess it's your first time with us.
When you say the way that you need to communicate, how do you establish that baseline in the beginning so that is as effective as it needs to be as you move through the relationship?
Okay, perfect. So I'm a gentleman, right? So I'm supposed to be gentle with you and a man with everybody else. So I need you to be gentle with me as well. Talk to me the way you talk to me when you like me. Don't talk to me based off your feelings. Talk to me based off your love. So talk to me the way you talk to me when you love me. When you upset with me, they should be the same way you communicate with me. The exact same. Because don't confuse me, because when you confuse me, you put me in a gray area. No relationship should ever be in a gray area. It's black or white. Either you love me and you're going to talk to me appropriately, or you don't love me and you're going to talk to me disrespectfully.
How old are you, sir?
I'm 34 with 3 years of therapy in me.
That's good, Mr. Daddy. I'm making sure you Saturday. Follow me. I'm gonna follow you back. Go ahead, Yella.
Sir.
Hey man, get him out of here, man.
We gonna dismiss. We gonna dismiss him after this question. But I am curious. Listen, with all of these jewels and gems that you're dropping right now, and the words that are coming out of your mouth is almost like honey to these women's ears. My question to you, my brother, is how are you so single?
So I'll put it out there. My last relationship, I got played, so I needed some time to heal.
Okay. Well done.
I moved to Florida.
Hey, what area of the country are you in? What state?
I'm in South Carolina.
See, this is
playing with her hair. She like
he's too young.
He's 34.
Ain't nobody
stop
trying to
stop it. Nah, he's old. He's 34. Fix your voice, 57.
Fix your voice, Mo.
Don't do that.
Mo, fix your damn voice.
If he too young, stop playing with your hair.
Thank you, Saturday.
That's what I'm saying. Hey, listen, and T. Michelle over there like this.
Hold on, Mrs. Saturday.
We can't do that, Coach James.
You don't get off either. You over there talking about.
Listen, what are you
saying, T?
Angel, you know that we know some things. So I had a million questions.
He sure did, Tommy Cole.
But see, here's the thing. What T. Michelle did, she said, this is Friday and this is Sunday. I need you in between. Sir, I need you in between.
Y'all are off the chain. Y'all, James, say, listen.
Yeah, she don't need no help.
No, okay, James, give us your last thought. James, Rory, Mo, Tanya, Yella, King, and then me and Coach Angela wrap up. Start with JT.
Well, I have two thoughts. One, I'm way behind at being single. I have the little South Carolina over here.
Just saying.
Is tough. I mean, he came with the honey and the milk all and stuff. He might as well just pour baby all on it.
Hey, if he was burning some candles and it was dim in there, I would holler.
Man, listen.
Man, you want to throw my bra? You said candle. Oh, shit, if I spank that one, we'd have been cussing him out the whole time. Mother, you said that.
Hey, Mo's so smooth. Mo is so smooth. JT is so good to see you. Give your website out one more time.
It is justbecon.com. JustBeCon.com. And here's my thing that I do want to say. I think one of the things that I'm joking a lot, but the reality of a good relationship has to be 95% communication. And that other 5% is really working on your body language when you're talking to that person, that they know that you are attentive to who they are. Because there's a lot of requirements that we may have for somebody, but how we present it is where the love really starts to begin. So justbecon.com. JustBecon.com. Love y'all, man.
Love you, man.
Hey, call me JT.
Come on,
call
Rory.
We need to talk.
Yes, sir.
I'm a pig.
Whoops. I got to get him back. Mo, you go ahead. Let me get Rory back.
Okay. So I'll start off with Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
That's it.
What
that's
I
a damn shame.
I'm playing. No, but I absolutely do firmly believe, you know, that it's the onus is on both parties to look out for each other. You actually do have to have each other's six, each other's three, each other's nine, each other's 12. Right. Okay, it's holistic protection all around on both sides. And just as men, you know, y'all expect women to listen to you when y'all tell us, hey, don't do that. Hey, watch out for that. Hey, look over there. You got to listen to us because we see things that y'all don't see. You know, what bus drivers, you know, we put our hands where your eyes can't see.
Right. Come on.
And y'all got to trust us. For what we see and what we tell you in the same breath that you do for us. So I think unless and until, you know, we can get to that, you know, mutually shared perspective, that's always going to be a difficulty. So in so much as I am willing to put my heart and my hands in yours, you absolutely have to be willing to do the same with me.
Hey, man, that's good. Mo. Love you. Hey, glad you're back home, okay?
Absolutely.
Love you, girl.
Come on, Rory.
Okay, two things. If Mr. Savvy was light-skinned, all y'all would be in the chokehold.
That's what they mess up to.
Listen, you know had me want to throw my drawers at the camera. You know what I'm saying?
hold on while you talk. Hold on. Like you got everybody laughing. Hold on. We dedicate this to Mr. Saturday, y'all.
Oh my goodness.
We dedicate this man, to stop. This stuff.
Say, man, stop. Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Okay. All right.
All right, come on, Rory, with your final thoughts. Rory, Tanya, Yella, then Kane.
I had a second point. God made Eve out of the rib. The ribs in the body, in the skeletal frame, were designed to protect the softer parts of the body.
Big facts.
Big facts.
So as a woman, and I'll speak to my woman.
whenever she decides to show up, or Jesus says, hey, here she goes 2 days before he comes, the woman is designed, designed to protect the inner parts of the man. Okay, the ribs are designed to protect the softer parts. I need my woman to be my rib cage. I need her to be able to protect my vulnerabilities, my insecurities, my heart. You understand? All my soft spots, I need her to protect.
Amen.
So say, not just shield. Okay, shielding is great, deflection is great, but the ribs were designed to protect. You know what I'm saying? They weren't designed to support. You know, we got the neck that supports the head, but they were designed to protect. I need you to protect my soft parts so I can go out into the world and protect
everything else. Hey, Robson.
Our union. That's all I got to say. I love y'all.
Love you, man. Love you, boy. I'll see you next week.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Come on, T. Michelle.
Hey, trust, respect is everything. A woman always is always going to be one step ahead of you guys. And that's not an insult, but it's just, it's the way that women operate. It's the way that we move, right?
Yeah.
And she's always going to be there to give you that insight that you may not have. Trust her, love her, and give it back to her. Try to be on the same page with one another and work towards the same goal. That's what it's going to take.
That's good. That's good, T. Michelle. And as soon as Alex's feet hit that floor of the dirt, I want you to call me, okay?
Yes, sir.
All right, my friend. Love you. Come on, Yellow. And then King.
Well, for me, listen, first of all, thank y'all for a great Wednesday session. I appreciate y'all.
Hey, Cynthia. Amen.
I definitely appreciate y'all. The word was out there. The laughter was out there. The information was out there. And I appreciate it all. What Roy was saying, I absolutely, chef's kiss to that. That was excellent. I'm going to go slightly in a different direction. It's one thing to protect. It's another thing to shield. My question to men and women when we talk about this protection thing is, do you know how to?
Because
not every shield has its truest function. Do you know how to use that thing? Do you know when to use that thing? Can you use it effectively? So if I'm shielding you, do I know how to do that effectively? If you're shielding me, do you know how to do that effectively? And when I say effectively, I'm not trying to defend you loudly, to make you embarrassed, call you out of your name, to make you feel uncomfortable. No. I need to learn how to defend you the best way possible so we can keep this union and this defense structure together. So if you're going to shield, if you're going to defend, make sure you know how to do it effectively.
That's good stuff. Hey, love you, man.
Love you, baby.
Give Scarlett my love.
Come on, Kane.
Always.
this entire conversation made me think about the time in my life when I told you I was a bit stubborn. And one thing I learned is that when somebody is in love with you and they're really in tune with you, so they know what's good for your spirit and what isn't.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd be a fool to not listen to that.
Yeah, say that for the people on the back row. Say that again.
Yeah. When somebody is really, really like in love with you and they really love you and they really care about you, they know what's good for your spirit and they know what isn't.
That's right. That's right. See, you weren't talking like this when you were 38.
That was only a week ago, man.
I'm being funny. It's a hard crowd tonight. It's a rough crowd tonight.
No, you're good.
It's 4 days ago.
King said that was 4 days ago.
Right. But no, that's all, man. Just being able to receive that protection and not fighting against the person that's supposed to protect you.
You're speaking a lot of wisdom, man. So like we asked Mr. Saturday real quickly. So what you're saying today is that you're more willing to listen today than you were when you were younger. You're much better listening now than you were in yesterday.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Even grass grow, man. You got to evolve.
Boy, you bet. Boy, you sounded good for B39, man. You sound good, man. You sound good. Love you, boy.
No, it's because he's got three best friends that are female.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff. So, Coach Angel, I really think the issue, and you touched on it a little bit, I really think the issue, and this takes time because Yellow spoke to it, it takes time to trust somebody to get to the level where you listen to them without thinking about it. So the real issue is trust.
I would agree 110%, 110%. If I trust you, then I trust you to lead us. I trust you to protect me. I trust you to be careful with my vulnerabilities. That's equally the same on your all's part. You know, when you trust me, you know that I'm the soft space for you to land. You know that I'm going to be looking out for you. And that when I do say something, hey, you might want to pay attention to this. And, you know, I actually have a tattoo on my left wrist, and it's a two.
Right.
And it's representative of the queen. So with the number one being the king. By design, the woman, the queen, you can put the weight of the world on her shoulders and she's just going to bend and bend and bend. She's bowed in submission on her knees to her king, which is the number one.
Come on.
I know this may be backwards, but she is the diplomat. She is the puppet master behind the curtain. She's, you know, the wizard behind the curtain. She's the one who prepares him daily for battle in the real world. And when he comes back home, she's the one who tends to his wounds of the daily battle that he fought for.
That's good.
I have very traditional values in that sense. If you want to know the queen's real power in a relationship, look at chess. In chess, the queen can go anywhere on the board in any direction as much as she wants to, anywhere. There's no restrictions. And the king and all the pawns are all to protect the queen. And there are very few moves in chess that once the queen is captured, that you can continue the game.
That's correct.
It can be done, but there's very few of them. And it's on the left because the queen always stands to the left. When you get married, your wife stood to your left. On the chessboard, the queen is to the left of the king on the chessboard. So I think that I personally did it as custom design just for my own. And it's pink and blue for traditional
men. Amen, Jennifer. That's good. That's a good word because, again, my attitude is with this topic tonight, I love my favorite superhero is Spider-Man. And my woman, a woman should be like Spider-Man. Spider-Sense is to him. A woman should be to her husband or her significant other. If I see that you are alarmed about something, that should trip my trigger. If you tell me something, we should be so in sync that when you speak, it stops me in my tracks, but it takes time to get there. And everybody wants this super microwave relationship. It takes time to trust somebody on that level.
Mm-hmm. Yep, absolutely it does. And I think in an instant gratification society that we have, we're looking for that instant love, that instant click, that instant, you know, everything. And I said, so
it takes time.
It takes time. You got to put in the work to learn each other.
It takes time. And that's the fun part. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. This has been a great live, y'all. We're going to go a few more minutes because this overtime, man, I don't get to see y'all but once a week. And when you come in my other lives that I do, we got over 16,000 likes tonight. We got 40 people strong staying with us. This is a great topic because speaks to you have to love that person enough to know that I'm not going to harm you. And love, another thing this speaks to, are you vulnerable enough? Hey, Chef, hey, Tammy, are you vulnerable enough? Are you willing to be vulnerable enough to put yourself in that vulnerable position to be able to listen to somebody? And love is a faith journey.
Oh, phew. It's a walk of faith for sure.
You know, you said something, and we talk a lot pre-production, and you said something that really, you touched my heart. And you said, Dr. Sims, and I'm going to chase a rabbit a little bit. You said, Dr. Sims, I'm being so careful this time because I don't have enough emotional latitude to suffer another heartbreak. Girl, I said, girl, you better preach. I'm ready to license you to be a preacher, girl. And that's so beautiful, because speak to the ladies tonight, because you are a coach and you hunt the good and you're very deliberate about who you let in your circle. And speak to the ladies tonight, since we have is Battle of the Sexes. Speak to the ladies tonight about how deliberate you are now, because you got to guard your heart.
Oh, wow. I'm very deliberate. I'm to the point where even if I decide I'm going to go out with you, I've already run a background check on you. Like, yeah. It's been that deep. I'm paying attention. I'm putting emotions aside, per se, yeah. and only yeah. going off of actions. I don't even care necessarily about your words, because I've had plenty of folks, talk those pretty words. Mm-hmm. I told somebody recently, I don't need all your pretty words. I don't. I need you to be real. And let me go from there. Let me see that.
Hey, Queen. That's right. That's good.
Very protective of myself, my mental, my peace, and my heart, because it is directly tied to my physical health. And I almost ended my life about 7 years ago over a heartbreak. And so, yeah, I don't have that in me to go through again. And it's a trigger to my illness, and if the stress, I can't do it. I just can't do it.
Yeah, so we have fine tuned your filter. If whoever gets through your filter right now, hey, we about to clone them, because you know your filter is tight. We got a very fine-tuned filter, y'all. Well, if y'all get in my coaching program, you understand what I'm talking about. But she's got a fine-tuned filter now. But tell everybody about the second book you're working on, and with your final thoughts, tell everybody about the second book that you're working on.
Okay, so the second book that I'm working on, it talks about how my company and my original journal came to be, Hunt the Good. It basically tells the story of how after divorce, I met somebody, and it was a fairy tale love. It made me question whether I ever loved, my husband. And it was just amazing. And then it wasn't. And it wasn't towards the end. And, after you break up, sometimes you guys hook up or whatever. We did that for 2.5 years. Only for me to find out that the last 6 months him and I were together, he was with somebody else, number one. Number two, that he was cheating on her with me for 2.5 years.
Wow.
I happened to find it by accident on a social media post. And it took 2 years for me to get over that heartbreak. The many conversations that I had with God about, please take the pain away. I mean, I physically hurt. I was shattered, to be very honest with you. And I can't begin to tell you the number of prayers I had morning and night to just make it go away.
Everybody's so proud of you. Jennifer, she says this is her first time here. If this is your first time with us, give us a purple heart. If you've been with us a while, give us 3 red hearts. But she says she's thankful that you didn't take your life. I said she's a real life angel, And tell people how they can get in touch with you.
So you can get in touch with me. You can be sure to follow me. Hit me in my DMs. And then I can exchange my email and my phone number and all that kind of stuff. I do have some slots for coaching available. The journal itself can be found in the link in my bio, and it's on Amazon. I believe Tomiko has purchased it. Bless her sweet little heart.
She's awesome.
Right. But it's a journey that I took myself on. So I coach the lessons I learned. And again, it came out of one day. I just woke up one day and it was, okay, what was the lessons in this? What is something good from this? What did you learn from this? What could you take from this? And it kind of talks about, the book then kind of talks about the journey of picking apart all the things that I learned along the way.
Yeah.
So make sure you follow me. Go ahead and hit me in my DMs. If you want the journal itself, I actually have it downstairs. I don't have it next to me now, but just click the link in my bio. It'll take you to Amazon. It is on sale. It's on sale right now for $23.99. So it won't last long, but it is there.
Yeah, that is so good. So good to see you. See you at the next Battle of the Sexes, okay?
I'll be here.
Thank you.
Love you guys.
Thank you, Angel.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed our talk tonight. Mr. Saturday said something, and and I hope everybody got this in your notes. And Yella talks about this as well, how he knows how to talk to Scarlett. My wife knows how to talk to me. And y'all may make light of this, but delivery is everything. At the end of the day, the Bible says in the book of Proverbs, an offended man is harder to win than a fence city. When you're going to talk to somebody and you believe you got the secret sauce, whatever that is, how you deliver that message is worth something. I'm a professional speaker. That's one of the things I do. I'm a life coach. I'm a pastor. I talk all the time. Everybody does not have my skill set. But you should really be deliberate when you say something to somebody and you want them to hear what you're saying. All right? And I'm working with another young couple, and I'm telling them to hear each other's heart. I told a young man this morning, I said, don't fall for the okey-doke when things are said emotionally. Don't fall for that. Hear the heart. And my challenge for everybody tonight is, if you speak and you want to be heard, watch how you say what it is you have to say. And if you do care about somebody, listen to them. All right? Okay. Thank you, Shan. I appreciate everybody tonight. We got to get out of here. I appreciate everybody. Thank you for the gifts. Thank you for the new followers. Thank you for my main followers that are here all the time. And I have a new talk show coming up. You just see that in my profile. You can see the advertisement. Thank you for your followership and your support. We love everybody. If you need me, you can reach out to me and DM me. If you need Coach Angel, reach out and DM to her. Good night, everybody. Really appreciate y'all. And remember, if you stay high on life, life is going to stay high on you.